Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Cattails. In the last episode, we celebrated Penny's birthday by buying her her very first accessory from Ember's shop, which of course was this adorable little red scarf that she's wearing right now, and we also received our next active skill, which was the Summon Allies ability, and that lets us call two of our forest colony friends to aid us in a battle in case we're ever a little bit too overwhelmed. We did give it a try in the last episode, and it helped us out a little bit, but unfortunately there were way too many enemy cats in the area, and we weren't able to successfully defeat that battle. Penny is still a little bit wounded actually from all of those battles that she got into before, but today we wanted to make our way a little bit closer into enemy territory to investigate the graveyard and the shady corners and whatnot that the mountain cats are hiding. I don't know if we're going to push all the way into their territory, the places where the blue tiles are, because that seems a little bit dangerous for a penny cat right now. She isn't exactly a master in fighting yet after all, so we might want to wait until we upgrade her skills a little bit more. That being said, if she can win a couple more of these battles, then we might be able to upgrade it today. And I think I did see that we have a couple of battles raging right on our borders, so I don't think Penny would take this sitting down. She would definitely want to make sure that her home is protected before she sets off for the day. So let's make sure that she takes one of her golden seals before she goes in there, because it does look like she needs a little bit of extra help, a little bit of extra healing thanks to all of her foraging skills. And there is that rare dragonfly again. Wait a second, guys. I know we need to go to the borders, but we need to get this rare dragonfly too. There we go, the banded darter. So I don't think we found this one yet, right? We saw it floating away in the autumn breeze one day, but we never actually caught it. So it's a rare red bug that emerges in autumn. Its wings have small bands of red color that give this dragonfly its name, and I'm sure somebody in this colony, somebody right here, would really enjoy it as a gift. For now, we'll plop it in here with all of the rest of our dragonflies, including the little blue dragonfly that we found too. Like, we really need to give some cats some gifts, I think. And maybe on the next day, after we take care of our battles and after we explore a little bit, we'll see if we can play around with the gifting system and hopefully get to know some of these cats a little bit better. But for now, since we have healed up, let's stick our little noses into this battle and see what's going on. Oh my goodness, there are so many cats here. Okay, let's go from behind. Since they're all kind of behind this tree anyway, we'll try to slap them right from behind, and there we go. I guess it worked. It was very, very hard to see because they were literally right behind the tree, but all of our cats did a wonderful job, which is good because we still had to wait a little bit longer for our Summon Allies ability to cool down. So we should have another battle right on below us. Let's sneak down here too, since we're still pretty relatively healed up, and we might as well try to get this bunny as well. If we can study our prey a little bit, we might be able to sneak up on this guy. Let's pounce. Yes, excellent. We need to store up our food too, our food supplies, because we are actually very, very close to the winter time. Just a couple more days and we will be in the thick of winter. So, hey Burke, don't scare away my mouse. Oh no, he did. He actually did, but there is another one up here. So let's try to get this one. Hopefully Burke won't get a little bit closer to us if we pounce now. There we go, just in time too, because he was turning to get his own little paws on that mouse first. But let's munch on the mouse since we are a little bit hungry. We'll go ahead and eat this, and then we'll stick our noses into the second battle of the day. There are so many mice around here. I don't know, maybe we should catch a couple of more since we are trying to stockpile our food. And we know that Scout likes these anyway. They're unfortunately not the harvest mice, but they are something. So let's scoot down in here and see, oh my goodness, how many cats there are. Oh my gosh, we only have two cats helping us out. This one might be a little bit of a problem. Yeah, look at this, look at all of these mystic cats. Well, I'm going to try to grab these blackberries and then run away, because I don't think we're suited to take care of all of those cats. Our fighting skills are not exactly up to par. So since we can't summon our allies either, I think we're just going to have to hope that we can find some lavender and then spread it into this area tomorrow when the battle is gone, because that is way, way too hard for our poor little penny cat. So I'm sorry guys, I tried my best. I tried my best, Missy and Mare, but we're going to scoot up to the north to see if we can find anything worthwhile, anything good to bring back, especially the lavender, because it sounds like we're gonna need it. So let's scoot off to the north. I think we're right on the edge of the map. So if we go straight up, we might be able to get to the shady corner that the mountain cats are hiding pretty easily. Though we do still have some blackberries over here too, don't mind if I do. We can munch on those along the way and then save all of our larger prey items for the winter to come. And the catnip too, excellent. We were looking for these because we did actually sell one off, one of Mare's very favorite catnip plants, to actually buy this red scarf. So we want to make sure we have a nice big supply of catnip for him, especially in the winter time. Let's study this guy though. Oh, look at that. We have a very, very small circle from the squirrels. Oh, this is gonna be a little bit tricky. Wow, I didn't know the squirrels were so hard for Penny to catch. That is quite interesting. Let's go for the mouse instead then, because that guy might be a little bit out of our league right now. There are a lot of squirrels up here though, so this would be the perfect place for Penny to really try to sharpen her skills. If she wants a big challenge, she can try to jump at these squirrels. Yes, you managed to get one. Excellent. So we will have plenty of food to last us through the winter at least. That being said, I think Doc is going to be very, very happy with us because we have so many golden seal plants in our pockets. We might actually want to use yet another one of them since we are a little bit wounded, but also to give us extra room because we haven't exactly purchased that inventory upgrade just yet. Ember does have one in his shop, and I believe the mole did too. This place is huge though. Look at this giant wide open field. There's not much else for us here to explore. There's not even any herbs kind of littered about the place. This is quite interesting. What is this called? The Canyon Plains, of course. So it's a giant, giant field. But here is the shady corner. The shady corner that the mountain cats have been hiding from us. And what better time to explore this area than in the middle of the night? It's already 12 a.m. too. So we have some valerian up here. We might as well snag this up while we can. And we'll see if they're hiding anything else, like right up at the very top. Oh, there's a cute little like grove here. This is adorable. There's nothing for us to pick up in the area, but that is a very, very nice place for a Penny to relax maybe if we weren't so close to mountain cat territory. I don't see anything else though. We have some plants over here. Have we actually been here before? Otherwise, one of the other cats in one of the other colonies must have picked it up instead. Oh, and not only that, but since the days have changed, it looks like the cats are still trying to take over this tile. A battle is still raging in that very same area, so that's not good to see. They must have heard that we had a little bit of trouble taking care of them, but let's take our first steps into the graveyard. Yeah, this place is really under mountain cat control too. Luckily, we can call our allies if, oh my god, we have any trouble with the ghosts and the zombies apparently. There are actually ghosts in the graveyard. That is absolutely wonderful. So let's try to get this dragonfly too before it scoots away. One of our graveyard dragonflies, we can give that to Lyrus because I'm sure it is chock full of many, many mysterious dreams. The mountain cats are pretty mysterious themselves though, considering that they're hiding this so close to their territory. So I don't see anything else that we can gather up aside from the mice in the area and all of these dragonflies and those ghosts. Oh my gosh, I wonder if there's anything super special that we can do here later on. We have some blackberries here, some tiny, tiny little golden seal plants way up in the corner. Okay, somebody was hiding that one too. And now if we go over here, we will be able to stick our noses into our very first mountain cat territory tile. So why don't we give it a try? Let's see if the cats are particularly attentive of Penny's presence. We are becoming little spies, sneaking around mountain cat territory. And look at that, they have some catnip in here too. Well, don't mind if I do. I will certainly steal that and bring it back to our den. We can give that to Mare. We can tell him as we were snooping around the enemy territory, we found all of these herbs, these wonderful plants, and now our pockets are completely full too. We spent the entire day, the entire night wandering around enemy territory, and we have plenty to show for it. We can't even take any more of this back unless we use one of our golden seals now. We could use that to heal up since she is still a little bit wounded, and who knows what we're going to run into. This would be the perfect time for us to learn how to warp too, how to warp straight back to our den, just like Coco showed off when we met him back when we were first introduced to the forest colony. That would be a definitely helpful skill to have so we wouldn't have to walk all the way back. And look at this, there's even more tombstones way out here. Okay, very, very close again to the mountain cat territory, so they really like to hang around the graveyards, I suppose. That's an interesting thing. I would have expected that from the mystic cats, but not so much the mountain cats. So we have more blackberries here, but unfortunately we're not going to be able to unpick those up. And we certainly can't swim across this river right here, so let's try to scoot around it. We'll move our way around all of the cliff sides too. I think we are, yeah, really, really close to where the mines are. We're going to have to give that another try too. We'll have to see if we can find any of those special shiny gemstones, because I'm sure he's still waiting very patiently for them inside his cave. We must be getting close to home now though, thank goodness. The fairy wood, I remember this place. We are very, very close to home. If we scoot off to the left, in fact, and wait a second, I think I saw another turtle. Oh my goodness, we have to at least try to catch the turtle, right? Let's study our prey and jump from behind. Oh no, but he can't get away that fast. We were able to take him down pretty easily, so we'll go ahead and munch on some of our blackberries since we are getting pretty hungry anyway, and we'll use one more of our golden seal plants so we can pick up not only the turtle meat, but also this special turtle shell. So we'll have to see if anyone around the colony likes the turtle shells. I think last time we caught one, I was thinking of giving it to Doc, actually, because I thought maybe he could store away some of his medicines or something inside the turtle shell. So let's see if Doc enjoys this as a gift. We know we can sell those off from, I believe it was 10 mews, which is a pretty decent amount, but I would prefer to see if somebody would want to become our friends if we give them a nice big turtle shell. So let's scoot over here, and Mare, you would not believe how much I have found. My pockets are full to bursting, but let's give Doc this lovely little turtle shell and see what he thinks of it. Hey there, how are you doing today? Pretty good, Doc. We're actually doing very, very nice because we had so many golden seals. Aw, you didn't have to do that. Thanks a bunch, Penny. Oh, look at that. He actually has three little stars. Oh my gosh, so we're getting to know Doc finally with all of the herbs that we've given him. He is finally on our side, or at least more so than some of the other cats. I could use some company right about now, I think. Glad he stopped by. Oh, that is adorable. Not everyone takes time out of their days just to chat it up with another cat. That's a sign of a real special cat right there. Oh, that is absolutely adorable. You know, we haven't actually really talked to Missy either, aside from that one time that she really insulted us, so why don't we give it a try with her too? Who are you and what do you want from me? Of course, she doesn't have three stars. She is not too interested in our presence at all. I'm a little bit occupied at the moment. Maybe if you stand over there a ways, I'll get to you when I'm available. You'll have to stand further than that, preferably far enough that you're out of eyesight. Oh my gosh, Missy, I am trying so hard to be your friend, but you are making it very, very difficult. Well, Mare, let's talk to you instead. We have your very favorite gift with us, so we know that you're going to be impressed. Let's give him the catnip too. How did you know that I love these? Thank you so much. Just a hunch, Mare. Unfortunately, he still only has some two stars as well. But yeah, I was curious to see if we could just give one of the cats, like, basically all of the gifts in our inventory. We have so many gifts sitting in our den anyways. Let's try to sort through these a little bit. If we place some of our extra prey items inside the pile right here, that might be a good idea. That way we can save this away for the wintertime. But let's go ahead and scoop up some of these damselflies, the blue ones, our special red one, of course, if we can grab that. There we go. We have way too many damselflies in here. It's so hard to navigate through all of our butterflies and whatnot. We might as well pick these up too, since again, they are out of season, just like the raspberries. Maybe Lyrus would really appreciate these summertime colors. We don't have any shells to give him, unfortunately, but we do have a plenty of colorful butterflies and, of course, our graveyard damselfly as well. Let's give him that one first, just in case we can only give him one gift a day. Ah, you bring a gift? My gratitude is boundless. It is much appreciated, my little rose. He does seem to appreciate all of these different colorful bugs, at the very least. And then the butterflies too, we know that he really liked these, so let's see if we can give him more than one gift. Oh yeah, we definitely can. My, how exquisite, how charming. Yeah, Lyrus really does seem to like the butterflies a little bit more than the damselflies, but I suppose you can understand that. He does really enjoy the colorful, beautiful, decorative items that you can find around the forest. Even the red butterfly too is just the same. So we could literally just stock him full of all of these bugs that we've caught, so we don't have to have it inside our den anymore? I suppose so. Like, imagine Lyrus going back to his own den now with all of these different bugs in tow. He is going to have so many bugs around his den, but at least that's going to give him quite a bit of inspiration as he's dreaming up all of his lovely dreams. We still haven't broken into the third star just yet, though. So I guess Doc really did love all of those herbs that we gave him if his friendship level went up so much faster. We have one more blue damselfly though, and then we'll go ahead and try to give him the red one too, just to see if he likes that anymore, since it is quite rare. We did just find this today, so hopefully you enjoy it. You bring a gift, my gratitude is boundless, just like all of the other damselflies. And we might as well scoop this one up over here too, so we can put another extra one inside our den. Something tells me that Lyrus is not going to want to see another damselfly in a very, very long time though. We just basically unloaded our entire stock of bugs straight onto his paws. It's nice to see that Doc is enjoying our presence so much at least. We did try very hard to get on his good side as we were increasing our foraging skills, so I guess it paid off in the end. But let's eat one of our squirrels and then let's go see if we can maybe take care of some of those battles. Since we can now summon our allies, it might be a little bit easier to do that than it was before. We'll scoot right down here to the battle raging directly to the south of us. Right by Lyrus's den too, like he must be a little bit concerned. Maybe that's why he moved closer to the mainland. Oh my goodness, no wonder. There are so many cats here. Max, get out of here. This lookalike cat with the blue eyes was going straight for us, and we definitely need to call in our allies. Lavender and Molly, give us a hand here, okay? It wasn't very much, and in fact, Fluffers and Squire are tearing straight into Penny yet again, so these mystic cats are really putting up quite a fight for our territory. That's a little bit concerning. We only have two more to go though, so we might be able to do this if we take one of the many, many golden seal plants that we found in our journeys toward the mountain cat territory. Let's turn around and slap this guy again a few more times, and then we only have one more cat to go, just Squire left. Let's hit him too if we can really, really quickly. He's a little bit worried it seems, so he must be close to getting defeated himself. Just a couple more hits, there we go. We actually did it, but that was super, super close. Only 28 points of health again. Let's definitely heal up a little bit. I think we might actually want to pay a visit straight to Doc this time. We have a 70 Mews inside our stash, so as long as he hasn't gone to sleep for the night, no, I still see him there. No wonder too, because he must also hear all of the commotion. Maybe he's going to stay up a little bit later tonight since we have so many battles taking place so close to the center of our territory. That would definitely unnerve any cat, right? So Doc, would you mind healing us up a little bit? We are your friend now, so hopefully you wouldn't mind giving us a bit of a discount too. Well, let's see about that. I can treat you fully for 16 Mews if you'd like, or I can just give you a small dose for 8 Mews. Yeah, treat me fully because we have yet another very, very large battle to dive into, and we did just use our active skill, so we're not going to be able to call our allies anymore. Let's see though, I think it was a little bit to the south, right next to that river. So let's see if Penny is strong enough to take on our second battle of the day. This was the one that gave us quite a bit of trouble last time though, so I can't say I'm feeling too confident. Honestly though, maybe we want to start pushing into the Mystic Cat territory because they are really, really going for ours. There's not as many cats here this time, there's only one more left, and I think our cats are going to take care of it. Excellent! Okay, so we managed to successfully defend our borders this time. All of the cats are gone, and now we have full control over this tile again, so that's good to see. We might want to come down here and hopefully spread a little bit of lavender if we can find some. If we could only find some of that extra lavender, then we could take over that tile too. But yeah, I'm starting to think that it might be time for us to maybe poke our noses into the Mystic Cat territory this time. So the Mountain Cat territory, honestly, wasn't too hard for us to wander through. We never found any battles. The cats were not very attentive. They were very, very lax on their borders, so we'll have to see if the Mystic Cats are the same. And we did find some very interesting things up by the graveyard there, so who knows what we're going to stumble into in the very mysterious lands of the Mystic Cats. But for now, Penny certainly needs to rest, and since this is the 9th of autumn, that means in the next episode we should be seeing some of our very first days of winter. I think we have one last day of autumn left, so I am quite curious to see what the winter has in store for our Penny Cat. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys!